Hi guys, today I am going to show how to create flowing frothy wave on the sea beach. You have lover's name written on sand too. An animated Valentine's Day card you can create for your loving one. So let's start. Create a new composition, size 3840 by 2160, duration 20 seconds, press OK. Then take a solid. Select golden color. OK. Now go to effects, noise and grain, and select add grain. Change preview to final output, none to Eastman color. Change resolution full to quarter so that it works smoothly. Change intensity 4, size 4, softness 0, color monochrome. Tint color can be a golden yellow. Now go to application. Blending mode can be overlay. Midtones can be 3. Change animation speed from 1 to 0. Check preview once with full resolution. Now again go to effects, then noise and grain. Add fractal noise, increase the contrast, change noise type to spline, we can increase contrast more, 150, change blending mode to soft light, brightness can be 20, now check how it is looking with full resolution. You can play more with light and shade to get interesting results. Change noise type spline to linear. I think linear looks good. Hide effects for time being for smooth work. Now select pen tool and draw wave. Now change the color. Change fill to gradient, select sea green kind of color, opacity 40. This side color should be a little dark to represent depth of the ocean, opacity 50, then OK. Now adjust the gradient. Depth of the sea can be a little more blue. Increase opacity to 60. Now animate the shape, content, shape 1, path 1, then path, then create 2 keyframes, save the file, name it Valentine's Day, now change the shape, it should look like wave changing one form to another form. Let's check. Change keyframe value to easy ease. Now go to graph editor and edit the value. Change fast frame value to easy ease out. Create a keyframe here, shift the key as third key, this will give you waves up down feel. Now another keyframe here, shift this one also as fourth key. Now copy and paste first keyframe here, so wave go back to its first position. Check once, edit graph of this key, should be first slow then speed up, let's see. Need to create few layers of wave, so copy and paste, change the timing, press U to see keyframes. Change the shape of the wave. Now go to first frame and change the shape. You can spend more time and play with the shape, and that's give you better result. Basically, it's all about time. Now create a keyframe, and this keyframe replace with fourth keyframe, and now delete this keyframe. Now create a keyframe here, copy the keyframe and replace this keyframe with fifth keyframe. And now delete it. Copy first frame and paste it to last frame. So finally, wave come back to its first position. Adjust the appearing time one after another. Go to first layer again and adjust two layers timing accordingly. Let's see how it is looking. Now duplicate this layer. We have to create another layer. Adjust timing. Go to any keyframe and change the shape so that it looks different from another layer. Create a keyframe here, copy this keyframe, go to fourth key and replace the key. Now delete the key. Now again, create a keyframe here, then copy and replace with fifth keyframe and then delete it. Change the shape of first keyframe, we have not changed yet. Go to last frame, copy first frame and replace with last frame. Now check once. Now copy this layer and paste on top of all layers. Adjust timing. Already we have created 4 layers of wave. Now we have to create white froth on the edges of waves. Duplicate this layer. Remove fill and add stroke. Select color, bluish white. Stroke size can be 30. Now add effects rough edges. Border can be 40. Edge sharpness can be 4. Now create border keyframe. Press U to see keyframes. Duration should be same as path keyframe duration. Starting point can be 30. Main thing of this effect is when we increase border thickness, then froth will be less. And when border line decrease, the white froth will increase. Now create a keyframe between two keyframes. Copy and paste at similar position of third keyframe and delete it. Create another keyframe. Copy paste or shift this keyframe. Similar position with path keyframe. Create another keyframe. Now increase border size to 60. See, froth is decreasing slowly. Now duplicate second layer, copy and paste. Do same thing like previous layer. Remove fill and add stroke. Stroke can be 25. Copy rough edges effects from previous layer and paste on this layer. Check once. Press U to see layer keys. Match the rough edges keys with path keys. Basically, you have to show froth coming with waves, then slowly disappearing when waves going back to ocean. I think we can remove this keyframe. Few bubbles are showing now. We can increase the quantity, so decrease the border size. Now it is looking okay. Now need to work on third wave. Duplicate layer. Same, remove fill, add stroke. Stroke can be 35. Copy rough edges effects. Now go to starting point and paste it. Press U to show keys. Adjust the keys. Increase complexity to 3. Here rough edges border can be 45. Now increase to 60. Now need to work on fourth and last wave. Duplicate this layer, remove fill and add stroke. Stroke size 35. Copy rough edges effects from this layer, paste it. Press U to rebuild keys. Stroke size 45 to 50. This can be 45. Or 55. Last frame can be 55. And now paste it. Let's see how it is looking. Now select all froth layer and move them to top. Now we have to create wet part of the sand. Now duplicate this layer. Press U, then remove all keys. Change color to black. This side also black. Opacity can be 50, 100 this side. Okay. Now adjust the gradient. Now change the shape. Change normal mode to overlay. Wave should play within wet area. Now switch on all effects and let's check output with all effects. We can increase the complexity of this layer. Change it to 3. Now select text tool and write your message. Choose handwritten kind of font and that will be more effective. Write your name. Now rotate the text little bit. Place it properly. Text color should be black. Now right click and go to layer property, then layer style and then bevel and emboss. Change setting up to down, then change its mode normal to overlay. Check out with full resolution how it is looking. Now change the bevel size. It can be 16, softness 0 to 12. Now again change full resolution to quarter resolution for smooth work. And also hide the effects for the time being. Now I am going to create some up and downs, some holes on sand. Select round shape. change color gradient to solid. Just create random different size dots. It's looking a little dark, so select deep yellow kind of color. Add effect rough edges. Change setting. Sharpness can be 5. Then right click and go to layer style. Then bevel and emboss. Go to bevel and emboss. And now change direction up to down. Size can be 10. Now change the depth. Hope 52 is fine. Now unhide all used effects and check. Change the mode of this layer, normal to oval layer. Check with full resolution. Actually, we can increase the depth of the rough edges. Sea beach scene almost done. Rename this composition to sea beach or beach. Now create a new composition. Name it crab. Size can be 400 by 400. Now we have to create a crab. So select rounded rectangle tool. Now create a crab. Select color like crab skin. Go to rectangle 1 under contents. Rectangle path 1. Now increase roundness. Create legs. This is not a bad idea to create illustration inside After Effects. Legs color can be little darker, little more darker. Send legs under body layer. Duplicate legs. Change scale to flip the legs. Shift the legs little bit. Now need to create eyes. Highlight the crab shell. Select eye layer and drag it below the crab's body. Now go to beach composition and drag the crab into it. Place some crabs into this composition and arrange them. Scale the crab. Add drop shadow on it. You can add more, it is your choice. Now take a new composition, HD size 1920x1080. Take a null object on 3D layer option. Then take a camera. Here is the camera setting. Okay, change camera parent none to null one. Oh, I forgot to rename this composition. So rename it to Happy Valentine's Day. Oh, sorry, S is missing. Now drag beach composition into this composition on 3D layer option. Select null layer. Press R to reveal rotation option. Create a key on orientation. Press P for position and create a keyframe. Press U to reveal keys. Create keys on 15 seconds. Now go to beach layer and hide the effect for time being and start animate. Rotate the camera. First show the playing wave. Then pan the camera towards the message. Now zoom out little bit to show full composition. Let's check the output. Just edit the text. Shift last two lines inside the composition. Change grabs position also to maintain the balance. Select last two keyframes, right click and go to keyframe assistance, then select easy ease. Your romantic card is almost ready. Now go to beach composition and unhide the two hidden effects. Now render and send to your loving one. And before doing that, if you like my tutorial, please press like button. For more such tutorial, subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.